Welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a comprehensive look at Monmouth County, the place you want to be. Monmouth County is centrally located in the state with 27 miles of Atlantic Ocean shoreline, nationally recognized parks, state-of-the-art libraries, school systems, and public services. Monmouth County is home to more than 660,000 residents. It's a great place to work and live. Monmouth in Focus will highlight county services that are readily available to you as a Monmouth County resident. Thanks for joining us for Monmouth in Focus. You'll know why Monmouth County is the place you want to be.
Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. Tourism is nearly a $2 billion industry here in Monmouth County, and with us today to explain just how important tourism is to the county's economy is the county's tourism representative, Jeanne DeYoung. Jeanne, thanks so much for joining us today here on Monmouth in Focus.
It's my pleasure to be here.
Pleasure to have you. Jeanne, let's talk about how important tourism is, not just in Monmouth County, but in New Jersey.
Tourism in New Jersey is a $37 billion industry. It is the fifth largest industry in the state of New Jersey. In Monmouth County, tourism is, as you said, almost a $2 billion industry. Mm-hmm. It's very important. It's an economic engine to the state and to the county.
You know, a huge amount of money. How does that affect jobs here in Monmouth County, especially in this economy?
Well, in this economy, tourism is very important because we've seen less cutbacks in the tourism industry than in other segments of the jobs in the state of New Jersey. There are 30,000 people in Monmouth County employed in tourism-related jobs. This is 10% of the county workforce. And our visitors, when they come, they spend their money on accommodations, $499 million, food, $439 million,
wow.
Transportation, $266 million, recreation and entertainment, $337 million. So all of this adds up and it affects the various sectors of Monmouth County. And it affects us countywide. It's not only our beaches, it's the entire Monmouth County.
Absolutely, because you know everybody thinks of Monmouth County, it's the Jersey Shore, but there's still so much more that it has to offer. We're going to talk about that in a little bit. But you know, summertime, you know, everyone flocks to the Jersey Shore. Mm-hmm. Lots of people love going to the beach, and like you said, they stay at hotels, they stay at bed and breakfast, they rent summer shore houses. Mm-hmm. It's crowded down here, let's face it. I know that there are some year-round residents who complain that, you know, it's just too busy, there's too much noise, there's too much traffic. But overall, year-round residents can benefit from this, correct?
Absolutely. You know, people who live here, particularly along the shore, know that from the months of June through September, we share our shoreline with the visitor. Mm-hmm. And that generates money and dollars into our coffers. If we didn't have a tourism industry in Monmouth County, every household would have to pay an additional $1,380 to make up for the lost taxes from that industry. So that's a pretty important number.
Any idea how many people actually visit the Jersey Shore every summer, an average, I would imagine?
Well, Monmouth County alone sees 4 million visitors a year. That's the county entirely. Most of that visitation takes place during the months of May through September, mm-hmm. where about 80% of that number is visitation solely to the shore. So that's a huge influx of people to our shoreline.
Absolutely. You know, people that are driving past Monmouth County, even going further down south, Atlantic City, will stop in Monmouth County as well on the way back to go to the beach here, on the way back to go to the restaurant that they've heard about.
Yes.
Especially during the summer months, would it be a drive destination?
Monmouth County definitely is a drive destination. Because of our location along the Atlantic Ocean and our proximity to the cities of New York and Philadelphia, they are our feeder markets. And we are less than about an hour away from New York City, about an hour and a half from Philly. And people do take advantage of that.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, our gas prices here in New Jersey are a lot less than those cities.
Absolutely. The gas prices, people are going to decide, you know, if they're looking to cut costs, we either go to the Jersey Shore or we go out to Long Island or upstate New York. New York gas prices are higher than New Jersey.
Yes.
They may opt to come here.
Yes.
And I know a lot of people who live in New York fill up their tank in New Jersey before going back.
They absolutely do. And actually, you know, we have our tax here. People shop here because our taxes are lower than New York on mm-hmm. goods. And, you know, we are a destination by default because of our location along the Atlantic Ocean. Mm-hmm. And people take advantage of our beautiful beaches. Mm-hmm. They come here, they spend money in our restaurants, they book our hotels and B&Bs. Monmouth County is home to over 4,000 hotel, motel, and B&B rooms. Plus, we have over 12,000 seasonal second homes that are rented out to the public.
Sure.
So this is a big number. We see a lot of people.
And when it comes to summertime, Jeanne, I mean, we really rely on Mother Nature as well, right? I mean, the number of people that come down here, it depends on the weather. If it's going to be raining all weekend, we're not going to the beach.
But there are so many things to do. People may come here for the beaches, but then they find out what else Monmouth County has to offer. We have terrific theater here. We have the Count Basie Theater, the Two River Theater in Red Bank. We have the Algonquin Arts Theater. We have the Axelrod Center for the Performing Arts. In Spring Lake, we have the Community House. All of these have wonderful productions. You can see Broadway quality entertainment at all of these places. And you know, we also have great museums. We're the only county in the state of New Jersey that has three historic working lighthouses that people can visit. And bowling, mini golf, people do come here specifically to play on our county golf courses too, because we have two courses that are ranked in the top 50 public courses nationally. And you know, that's Hominy Hill and Howell Park. And that's a great option for people. If you're a resident, it's even better.
It's also important to mention our parks, just some beautiful parks throughout the Monmouth County Park System.
Absolutely. You know, we have one oceanfront park, that's mm-hmm. Seven Presidents. But, you know, we have Homedale Park, and then you have historic Longstreet Farm. You right. have historic Wallingford. These are great options for people to visit and spend a day. They're in beautiful areas. It's a nice, relaxing time. And our park system is second to none. Our park system is the number one ranked county park system in the nation. We are the model for the nation for county park accreditation. So that's an important factor.
Something to be commended for, too.
Yes, absolutely.
And with tourism on the rise, how important of a role is it for the county to play in local tourism?
The county takes great pride in promoting tourism. We have taken great steps in advancing our website. The county website is a ready resource for people to view. We have a tremendous selection on the website. We have an excellent calendar of events. If you want to know what's going on in Monmouth County, the calendar of events is a great resource. Mm-hmm. We have a complete listing of the hotels, motels, and B&Bs. We have all of the campgrounds. We have all of the historic sites. We have all of the theaters. So it's a ready resource. And the website is www.visitmonmouth.com. And on the top, that's the county homepage. Mm-hmm. On the top, just click on the tourism button, and it will take you right there. And all this is a ready resource. The freeholders, the Board of Chosen Freeholders, realizes the importance of tourism and how it supports businesses. And we are now having a presence, particularly this year, at special events and festivals. 2 weeks ago, we were at the Belmar Seafood Festival. About 180,000 people visited that festival in a weekend. It gave us, the county as a whole, the opportunity to inform residents and visitors alike of everything that Monmouth County has to offer. And we will be at Ocean Fest on July 4th in Long Branch. So that's another opportunity for us to promote Monmouth County.
Absolutely. And you're even doing more new things this year. Tell us about some of them, Jeanne.
Well, we have a new tourism logo, and that's on Facebook and Twitter. Mm-hmm. And this is, you know, new for the county. And we hope that in the coming months and through the fall, this will be a resource that people will use to find out what's going on in Monmouth County, what events they can attend, what new happenings are taking place. So, you know, this is social media has really taken on a new initiative for the county.
Absolutely. You know, Facebook and Twitter, people will just log on and they could get to it by their phone. It's a quick way to find out information.
It absolutely is a ready resource. Most people have, you know, phones that where they can, they're 4G and they can get everything mm-hmm. at a moment's notice. And if they're on the beach one day and they want to find a restaurant or if they want to find out what's going on, hey, it's available to them almost immediately.
That's amazing. So the information about local restaurants, about, like you say, theater in Monmouth mm-hmm. County. Really, I think that's one of the best kept secrets in Monmouth County. You go into the Count Basie, you do feel like you could be in a theater in New York. You go into the Two River Theater, totally different theaters, but mm-hmm. but beautiful theaters.
Absolutely.
You know, in the Paramount Theater in Asbury Park, you know, they put on some wonderful performances.
Absolutely. And this year, upcoming at the Count Basie, you can see Clint Black, you can see Kelly Pickler at the Great Auditorium in Ocean Grove, which is an historic site. But it also offers top entertainment. Neil Sedaka is going to be there. Bobby Vinton's going to be there. Mm-hmm. Johnny Mathis is going to be there this summer. So, you know, these are all great venues for people to take advantage of. Also, you know, families who are living on a strict budget with the economy the way it is, too. There are a number of concerts that are free on the beach and in the park. There are a number of places that people can go where they're, you know, it's not going to cost them, you know, museums and things like that. So people can take advantage of all the great things that Monmouth County has to offer. These are all assets to us. And people come and they visit. And our residents also visit these locations also.
And again, it's real important to stress that, you know, obviously tourism during the summer is about the beaches, but what about the other seasons? There's still a lot to do here, even if you don't live in Monmouth County.
Absolutely. As we get into the fall, it becomes more of your harvest home festivals. A lot of the towns and municipalities realize how much money the visitor brings in, and they'll host festivals at various times during the year. And then also, all of the farms have pick your own. And of course, as we get closer to Halloween, it's pick your own pumpkins, pick your own apples. And then, you know, of course, as we get into November and December, there are a number of holiday productions that take place. Right. You also have Christmas tree lightings and menorah lightings in the municipalities, which is great. The winter months are, you know, we're a four-season destination.
Right.
People can cross-country ski in our parks. People can sleigh ride in our parks. People can ice skate locally. So, you know, there's something here for everyone in every season. Monmouth County Tourism also has a toll-free number that people can call. It's 1-800-523-2587, and then press number 3. And they can request a tourism guide, maps, information on events, and we mail it out to them, or we direct them to the website.
Okay.
So
and
we're,
the website?
We're available.
Again, thank you so much, Jeanne, for
thank
joining
you.
Us today. It sounds like you have a great job, busy job, but it sounds like you love your job.
I love my job.
Okay. Jeanne, thanks so much for joining us today here on Monmouth in Focus. That is all the time we have right now. For more information on tourism, you can go to www.visitmonmouth.com. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.